But think of the disastrous effect this might have on the morale of an American teenager. No, I'm not suggesting the boy doesn't want to go to the army. It's just that, well, no, it's not that. Well, it seems to me that 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Rosie! Oh, thank goodness you came. This is the end of the Alabama Music Corporation. Conrad Rudy is going to the army.
And your favorite secretary is hereby submitting a resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't leave. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? The little white ones I take are overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Bring it in hand.
Albert, you're 33 years old. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I am a long way from 33. I will be 33 until tomorrow. Water.
It's no use, Albert. My mind's made up. I've been with Amelie 8 years now, and as you well know, I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rosie, those are moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness in the office, I put in a 9-hour week. And for what? A $5 raise in 1954 and a bottle of Arpege last Christmas?
Promise her anything, but give her Arpege, Rosie.
Yeah, but not a 1/16 of an ounce. Besides, I want something more than that.
Rosie, if you're referring to a more permanent nature between you and I, I'm not ready for it. Besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that, too. Amelie is me, Mama, and Lou. And any changes in it would kill the wonderful woman who bore me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert. Except for maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor old Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
And I loved him, too. Sure, he was warm, he was loyal, he was lovable. But he died 6 years ago. And besides, he's a wiry terrier. Anyhow, this is something much more important.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I am in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. When I've already spoken with the army, I quit. There's nothing you can do but go back to college and get-
Rosie! I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad has a $50,000 guarantee which I can't pay. And I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me? I'm serious. His going in the army is the best thing he can do. Now you're free to start to do what you want to do. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be 4 years, but it's 8 years, Albert.
me. Help me get the money to pay back Conrad's guarantee. And as soon as my uncle read, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic one.
Albert, you're wrong.
Of course, it may take a couple of years, but I'm sure by 1973 or 74, the latest will. What's that?
Something that's going to push that date a few years. Here, pick a name.
Pick a name? What are you talking about?
I'll do it for you. McAfee, Kim McAfee, age 15, president and recording secretary, Conrad Brady Fan Club, number 274, Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, would you get me Sweet Apple, Ohio? The number's capital 78820, and call me right back.
Now wait a minute, what's going on? Who's Kim? Whatever her name is.
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I've never heard
it. Well, that's because you haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is from Conrad Birdie going into the army for 2 long years, and when he gives that one last kiss to one of his bands, chosen at random from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Mr. Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
I'm beginning to see it, Rose. We'll cut the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bum with playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rosie, it's brilliant, and I promise you, as soon as this whole thing is settled, it'll be just the two of us, in perfect bliss. I'll get a job teaching English and... bliss. Kiss! That rhymes! I wonder if anyone's used it before. Oh, what difference does it make? It'll be a great song. Oh, one last kiss. It gives me so much bliss. What does your dentifrice nose do?
This. giving up the scream? You mean when Conrad Bernie sings on television, you're not going to go, ah! Oh, Cam!
Cam, dear, would you please get off the phone? I've got some calls to make.
All right, Mother. Sorry, Ursula. I've got to hang out. You'll explain everything to the other kids, won't you?
I suppose we'll have to. Bye, Kim.
Oh, and Kim, are you sure? I mean, really?
I'm absolutely sure.
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old, and it's time I settled down.
When you're a skinny child of 14, wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be appealing. Then hallelujah, you are 15 and the braces disappear, and your skin is smooth and clear, and you have that happy grown-up
Conrad.
think she still has a few good years left. Why don't you girls head down to track 12 and I'll talk to her. And stay out of the bar.
You know?
Hi, I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Oh, come on, things can't be that black. Smile.
As an adult speaking, I order you to smile.
Please.
Guys are gonna clear up, put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up, put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy, it's not your style. You look so good that you'd be glad you decided to smile. Take out a pleasant outlook, stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that pull up down look, slap on a happy grin. So spread sunshine all over the place, just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face.
Nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man doesn't snatch her off. A person will make
weddings and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent.
Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peace.
Now, Mom, what I wanted to talk to you about is sort of about Rosie. Perhaps you better sit down.
Why?
I know my sonny.
He loves his mama. He wouldn't say anything that would break his mama's heart. Go ahead, dear.
What about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou, too.
Lou! Where are you, Lou? Stripped down by a beverage I consumed faithfully for 32 years. What about Lou?
Well, Rosie thinks, and I agree, that we should give up Alma and Lou. Mama, what's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. You killed me, that's all.
Oh, Lou, don't worry. I'm coming. I'm on my way up.
Mama, you don't understand. It's just that Rosie thought, Mama, look. Here's some money. Take a taxi home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing's too crowded for a mother. I'll take the IOT. That's the worst subway. Wait a moment. How many blocks is it after all? Only 107.
I'll walk.
Mama!
Enjoy yourself, sonny. Take care. Wear your heavy coat.
Oh, be careful crossing the street. Oh, wear your rubbers.
And eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought you said you were going to break it to her gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rosie, I didn't tell her at all. I mean, she was so upset about my leaving that I thought I'd better wait.
Meaning you didn't.
He's coming! He's coming!
Trenches, that we all be sure to get one of those dirty chairs.
Robert!
Who's ever dirty this?
stop by
Kim,
in a second.
Kim, before you go, can I talk to you for a minute?
Right now? I mean, couldn't it wait? I'm in an awful hurry.
I don't think so, Kim. It's important.
You go, Peabody. What's so important that you have to talk to her right now?
What's so important? I'll tell you what's so important. The day after I give her my pin, she goes around and kisses someone else. That's what's so important. I want you to know I'm quite upset about this. I've already had two headaches and a nosebleed.
I'd say you're actually jealous of Conrad, Bertie.
Me jealous? I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous, and I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
That's just it, Hugo. I'm your steady.
Well, I may admire Conrad for you. It's one of mine is a far distant and unattainable ideal.
But I'm kin to you, Hugo. And I don't care how common and ordinary you are. That's what I'm going to say.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better?
I mean every word of it, Hugo.
Oh! present to you this 14-karat solid gold key, so generously donated by the men of Sweet Apple Brass Rings. That's my gift as keeping you on, right, Birdie?
He said he was everything!
What happened? All I said was Conrad Birdie. If you girls don't stop that, I can't finish my speech.
Oh, who cares about your speech? We want to hear from Conrad. Speak to us, oh beautiful one. Tell us how you make that glorious sound that even now the anticipation of it has reduced me to a sound of amazing, fancy, jungle beat.
You've got to be sincere.
What's the matter?
You've got to be sincere.
Mr. Burns, pardon me.
You've got to be sincere. Cause if you feel it here, well, then it's got to be. Honestly. If what you feel is true, really feel it too, make it feel it too. Write this down now, you gotta be sincere, honestly.
Oh,
and 26 to go, so sing.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and we'll be true when you're not near us. We're blue. Oh, Conrad, we love you.
Dad, I wish you'd hurry. I want to have all this mess cleared away before Conrad comes down.
This mess, as you call it, happens to be my breakfast. And I intend to enjoy it.
Your father has a right to enjoy his accident. But I'm sure he won't mind if we just quietly start clearing away some of these other things. I know the house has been a bit like a mess, but Kim's gone to a lot of trouble to fix this special part of this woman's security. And I just want to make sure everything's ready when he comes down. After all, I want to show these New York professionals. I don't want to treat national figure here to get out. Of course, it doesn't mean much to me, but for Kim's sake, there we are. All done. Did you enjoy it, dear?
Good.
Now, hurry along.
Doris, I'm not budging from this chair, and so I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I didn't have time to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pop. Here's today's paper. Thank you. I hope you don't mind, but I cut out a few stories about Conrad. I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination to both the women I have married and the children I have sired. There's been no taxation without representation, and open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as Fats. Telephone calls were made to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong? I slept in the campfire with my feet in the fireplace and my head in an ashtray. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad!" 4,723 times. I had just lost two fried eggs! Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament has been dissolved, the Magna Carta is revoked, and Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm 7-Up.
Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind staying off the phone for a few minutes. We're expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfect, you're all right. I'll go out and burn Rome.
Mother, what's wrong? Nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad being here. That's all.
He's coming. He's coming.
He's coming. I'll get the eggs. Mother, you call the kids.
Girls, he's coming. You'd better hurry if you want to watch him eat.
Here he is.
Me,
on the Ed Sullivan Show. Ed Sullivan. Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan.
On the way here. A wonderful reply. fine girl on her way to Akron. Only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, say hello to Gloria Rasputin.
Last kiss. Mama.
soon that Conrad gets to bed.
Oh, wait for me, Conrad! Albert, for the last time, you get out of my way!
I'm going out to town tonight, and I don't want to waste another minute.
Not until I have my say, Rosie. I just wanted to let you know that thanks to Mama's quick thinking, the kiss will take place after all. Tomorrow morning, just before the train pulls out. So I guess I could say that you failed, Rosie, as anyone must fail in trying to buck Al Peterson, one of the giants, the titans, one of the King Kongs of the music industry.
What did I ever see in him? How could I ever think that he was nice? Take it from me, I paid an awful price. It was rough.
Means to me, Conrad! Conrad!
Take it easy, I'm coming.
tired of waking up at 9 every morning, having people watch me while I eat, letting kids poke me in the eye. I want to go out, have fun, meet a couple young chicks. Don't you get it, Albert? I'm tense.
Mama, go just sit there and do something.
Hey, Conrad, have you ever thought in terms of a more mature?
Oh. Man, I hope I never get that tense. Now listen here, buddy boy. This is my last night before going in the army, and I am going out.
You can't go out without my permission. It says so in your contract. Mama, get the contract. It's in my... Never mind. I'll get it myself. Conrad, you stay right here.
Oh, Conrad.
There are chicks just ripe for some kissing. And I mean to kiss me a few. Man, those chicks don't know what they're missing. I got a lot of living to do. There are steaks all ready for tasting. There are Cadillacs all shiny and new. Time is a wasting. I got a lot of living
about?
They're out together having moonlight swims and motorboat races and loop-the-loop. I'm going to do the only sensible thing and drink myself to death.
Moonlight swims, motorboat races, loop-the-loop?
Do I skip my gun?
No, but I intend to see him, Mr. Peterson. So if there's something you would like me to tell him, I'll gladly deliver it right after I shoot him.
Shoot him? Rosie! I've got to find Rosie!
Dear, what are you talking about? You know you don't have a gun.
There's the Daisy air rifle in the garage.
That's mine, Pa.
You shut up.
Anyway, it's broken here.
Then give me something. Bow and arrow I got you last Christmas. Well, suction tips. Well, don't just stand there. My daughter's run off to loop the loop with a fiend. Give me a water gun. Kids, I don't know what's wrong with these kids today.
Kids, who can understand anything they say?
Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs.
Rosie, please.
Talk to me. Father, you'd marry anything.
Sonny Boy.
My name is not Sonny Boy.
Good night. Albert!
Pleasure to see you again. Unfortunately, I must tell you, Conrad's affairs no longer interest me. I'm here looking for Rosie, now to tell her that Conrad and Kim?
They went off together.
And if we don't find them soon, Mr. Peterson, I intend to call the FBI.
Isn't Jonathan out here? Is it Peter Lawford yet?
Okay. I'm sure there's absolutely nothing to worry about.
Harry, don't worry, son. We've seen Ursula.
Ursula?
Ursula. Is she missing too?
Since 10 o'clock, and I have looked everywhere.
Mr. Peterson!
Matthew, you have some party, have you?
For Roger and Phyllis?
I'm sure we're all down at the drugstore. Probably having one of these gang wars.
Gang wars?!
I don't see why anybody wants them.
Just you wait and
kids, they are just impossible to control.
The old enough to
kids, with their awful clothes and their rockin'
other teenage delinquents.
Why can't they be like you were, perfect in every way?
What's the matter with kids?
Two kids, what the devil is wrong with these kids today? Who could guess that they would turn out that way? Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way?
What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids?
What's the matter with kids
about. I can get you a fix if you tell me what it is, when you've had a donkey on your back as long as I have.
That's nice. Now, out of my way, I'm late.
But you don't understand. You said it yourself. We got a lot of living to do.
Now wait a minute.
We'll never go home again. We'll follow you to the ends of the earth.
We'll try to swim.
Motorboat races.
Yeah!
Of course, that stuff really ain't as much fun as I made it out to be.
And we can start right now. Let's have an orgy!
Tacos and the enchilada.
happy name next to me, Wu Chen. Sister of Spanish beauty, Kei Sen Ra. You like me? Yes? No? Maybe?
Because they prefer the applicants to be married.
Perry.
Oh, Albert!
Rosie, did anyone say that's the most beautiful name in the world?
First of all, they did great. I wanted to mention one thing tonight.